All right, 2,000. Let's go for another fire. Bulldoze. Yeah, that does a little bit more. Let's go ahead and heal now. Overall, though, if you've been leveling Kimahri up with everybody else, it should not be too difficult for you. One more. As long as he doesn't heal, I like my chances here. Plus, it's 2-on-1, and that's cheating. I'm the only one allowed to have numbers in this game. I think it's time for a Ronso Rage, yeah? Which one do I actually want to go to? But we do have Doom. Counts down to an enemy's Doom, and we have White Wind restores party's HP. I don't like it because it's an overdrive, and we don't have access to that too much. All right, let's go for a jump. We'll hope for the best. How much do I need? I think I need 2,200 in order to get this overkill. 2,500. So I don't think that's going to happen. Yeah, we only got 1,000, but we won. He died. He goes for Berserk. Let's hit him with some Fyra. If it's an overdrive, it's not my favorite to go for it. Damn, that's a lot of damage. High potion, please. Another bulldoze. Damn, he's doing a lot. Let's go for the X potion. I have 16 of them. I don't like using them, but now seems like a good time. I don't have anything to dispel that, do I? More fire, I'd be run. Fire. I don't remember him doing this much damage. It's a lot, though. All right, we'll go for another X potion. You do have to have a lot of items for this one. All right, what's he down to? 29, so it's still going to take a little bit of work for me. We got one more. Now this one I've never been able to get the overkills on. They do have variable stats. Their stats are entirely dependent on Kimahri's stats. Well, not entirely, but for a good chunk of it, they are. Like, their HP, for instance, is entirely dependent on how much you've been leveling up your Kimahri. So I recommend leveling them up quite a bit. All right. I got 2 turns at this. He's got 660. I should be able to do it with another Fyra. And down goes Biron! You weren't expecting...
Kimahri Ronso.
You weren't expecting a magic Kimahri, were you? And Kimahri has won, getting himself 9,000 AP, which sounds like a lot, but it's not even enough for the next sphere level. I got a couple return spheres out of that, a sorcery armlet and another halberd. We'll have to take a look at those.
Strong is Kimahri. Biron is happy. Sacred Mount Gagazet, I honor the name of strong warrior who defeats Biron. Remember always, Gagazet, that name is Kimahri. Mountain knows Kimahri strong. Kimahri may pass. Summoner, we Ronso will stop pursuers from temple.
Truly?
Penance for breaking Kimahri's horn long ago. We crush enemies following behind.
Kimahri crushed enemies standing before.
You are most fortunate, summoner.
I thank you.
Ronso will shine your statue brightest.
Thank you. But I fear that no one will make a statue for a traitor such as I am.
Then Ronso will make. With Grand Horn on head.
That would be wonderful.
I wanted to see Yuna's statue too, but I wanted to see it with Yuna by my side.
I was real quick at the end there, but we got redemption for Kimahri. That's something. Let's head back and, you know, get him his health back. That'd probably be useful. I should say that if you get Baron down, you can learn Mighty Guard instead of White Wind like we got from Yankee, and we'll also change Kimahri's equipment. A lot of people recommend the Night Lance for this one because obviously it increases his strength by so much, but I wanted the sensor. I wanted to see what I was doing, you know? That is kind of important to me. So where is that magic plus 20? There's that halberd. The halberd that we picked up just has piercing on it. We also got ourselves an armlet, but I have not changed armlet for a long time. MP plus 20%, that is entirely unnecessary for Kimahri. So there's that. But we have ourselves a path forward. So let's head up Mount Gagazet. We got redemption for Kimahri. Everybody's happy. Bronn's a little upset that he lost, but he got over it.
What is it this time?
E-A-U-E. No. Re-en-me-li. Yo-tru-yo-go. Ha-san.
That was great. Let's go with that. Over here, though, we can find ourselves 2 mega potions. Now we want to head up here, I believe. Oh, we got some new enemies first. We have ourselves some grots and a Bashura. Be careful if it's put up its dukes. Let's go for the grots first, even though the Bashura is going to go first. I don't stand a chance of killing him first. Right, immune to water. There's some damage. He's got 2 little arms in the front. I don't think I pointed that out. All right, these guys are weak to fire after all. Let's use fire on one of them and probably kill it. Lulu is strong. Here comes the seed cannon. In case you don't have that already, now's a good time to learn it. Let's bring Kimahri in. Kimahri. Go for a Fyra on the Grot. As you can see, he's starting to pick up. He is starting to actually have some damage. Let's hit the Bashura to start. All right, finish off the Grot. As you can see, the enemies around here are not really messing around. We'll kick you out, bring Waka in, who I don't think has had a turn yet. We'll go for a dark attack. See if that was good enough. Doesn't look like it. Orin! Couldn't do it. Riku, come in! Got a soul spring. Probably should have gone for the mug. And Riku has learned in overdrive mode. I've been learning a few of those. Nothing spectacular, though. Nothing I want to change to. Lulu was the first one to get Victor, though. That's interesting to me. That was a lot of damage. All right, let's bring Yuna in. Go for Prey. Yeah, not all that much. Let's go for Waka here. Dark Buster. Actually landed this time. All right, he's got his hands in the air, but I do think he cares. Let's go for Orin. Yeah, he likes to counter. Waka finishes the job. The fights are not always too easy around here. All right, 3,800 AP. And I need to heal. Now, I believe I want to head up here and down. Because way... No, that's not the right way. Not quite there.
Much has changed in 10 years.
Well, we're fighting the exact same enemies that we did last time, too. You didn't bring that up, did you? Let's try this again. Up here. And then... It should be around here, I thought. But we have a new enemy along the way. These guys have been pretty tough. I was going to go back to the safe sphere anyway. But now I got ambushed, and now I know I will. Mostly because Lulu is using a ton of magic. She does not have enough MP to really counter how much she needs in terms of the third level elemental spells that I'm using. All right, I only have 10 more uses of those. They cost 16 MP. Let's go for a Fyra. Kimahri's pretty good at this. He has the means to get that back very quickly with the Lancet. Lulu does not have that, unfortunately. That makes things a little bit more difficult for me. All right, that wasn't too bad, but I am confused. And Titus can't even hit himself. Or Kimahri. He missed there, too. All right, let's start bringing other people in. We'll start with Waka. Lulu, go ahead and finish that off. This is why it's difficult to use her to her full potential. Like I said, we're going back. Okay, that was bad. Let's bring Orin in. He did quite a bit of damage. Not sure it's going to be enough, but... Titus, it would be great if you stopped hurting yourself and others. Alright, he's back. Let's bring Yuna in. We're definitely going to go back to the save sphere now. He is not back. He is still confuzzled. Let's go for an Asuna and fix that. What are we at?
See ya.
Okay, that was way more damage than I thought he would do. Way more. As you can see, Lulu does not get any experience as a result. Neither did the other person that was not in the party. Super! Alright, we're good to go again. There we go. I just had to go right a little bit more. Then we have access to this treasure chest over here with 20,000 gil. But like I said, I would like to go back to the save sphere. Let's hope I do this fight properly this time. Yeah, let's head back. The enemies around here, pretty difficult. Especially when they get the jump on me like they did once or twice. So let's head back here. I did get a sphere level. Let me take care of that. Really quickly, I moved Kimahri, got himself more MP. Then I got Yuna a step closer to something else. Lulu got more MP, 40 more MP, and 4 more defense points. That's some nice stuff down here. Riku got herself more agility. Titus moved. Orin moved, and Waka got himself more strength. 4 more points there. All right, ready to move forward. We have a long journey ahead of us. Let's hope that it all works out well. Mount Gagazette is not necessarily the easiest place, but we will make it through it. We already got ourselves a couple of the side pieces, and now we have more enemies. Let's bring in Waka. He's good against this thing. We have 2 grenades and an imp. Let's hit the imp. Hey, look, down it goes. Yeah, all right, let's go for just a focus. Then we'll have you do a Thundaga on the grenade. Or Blizzaga. Did I say Thundaga? I might have. As you can see though, not as effective as I would like. I feel like I'm missing something. Tidus? Feel like it's resistant to magic a lot more than I anticipated.